Hey, yo, what up, sluts? This is Taylor, and it's been a little bit. I mean, YouTube has been kind of bending me over the table recently and having its way with me as far as video uploads go, because it has been probably 3 or 4 days now that I've been able to upload a video, and it takes forever, and then I can't upload a second video for some reason. I just haven't been able to upload more than one, like, the last 3 days. So my bad, I'm gonna try and get two up today. If not, so sue me, you know. Maybe if I can't get it up more than once a day, I need to go talk to my doctor, but that's not a problem. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoy this video because you hear that in the background? Do you hear that? No, you don't freaking hear that because I turned off all of my fans and I'm sitting up here in the sweltering heat, sitting in ball soup, not feeling very pleasant at all. And now my dog's leaving my room and he's making noise. See, hear that? God damn it, Boz, ruining my perfect quality of sound. Anyway, on to the questions and topics you guys wanted, and as per usual, or as I'm trying to make this usual now, I'm going to start with the people who ask first. That seems novel, but you know, here we are. So, Tanner C15, what do you think is the dumbest superpower? P.S. Love your channel. Thank you, Tanner. In my opinion, the dumbest superpower would have to be flight. And I know that's going to step on a lot of people's toes because when they ask, they say, "Oh, superpower! I want to be able to fly." It's like, well, what the hell? What is the point of that? I mean, like in my everyday world, I'm perfectly fine using my car. You know, I'm perfectly fine with that. And also, if I'm just soaring around, like just you know, trying to be inconspicuous, just flying like just right over the road, like I don't know how fast I can fly. I'm not sure. Maybe I can make it a stipulation that I have to be able to fly like 90 miles an hour or something ridiculous. Like I'm just going to be soaring around. People aren't just going to pretend that I'm like you know not there. They're not just going to be like, "Oh, there's that guy who flies around, you know, this intersection every so often on his way to work." Like, no, people are going to stop me. Police are going to accost me. They're going to shoot at me out of the air. And so it's really a superpower that you can only use if you're confident that nobody can see you doing it, because then the government will get you and they'll perform DNA tests. I know this is a fact. I mean, I read something about it on the internet, so trust me. So flight, not very appealing. Something that you can hide, much more appealing. Like, even if it was just something just brutal and just destructive, like the ability to summon fire from your hands and just like throw molten fireballs everywhere, like that would be better than flight. Because obviously, the only time you're ever going to be throwing molten fireballs is if you want someone to see, you know? And they're not going to want to see it. It's going to be scary, like the end of a movie or something. But man, I have given you way too much time, Tanner. On to the next person. Penner's Gaming YouTube. A dual com with me. Just kidding, your opinions on gun control. I actually did a video on gun control. I explained that I am in favor of guns, at least in the US at this juncture. But for the most part, I feel like it's completely overdone and it completely misconstrues the intentions of the Founding Fathers. But hey, what are you going to do? Oh, hey, I'm Balls. Oh, well, hello, Balls. Your thoughts on police officers being total dickheads? I don't think that all, well, I know that not all police officers are total dickheads, but the reason that they are dickheads, for the most part, at least, and this is all speaking from personal experience, I'm not going to pretend like I went to some cop convention and met like 50,000 of them and have established a well-researched and thought-out proposal as to their respective personality traits in comparison to the general population, saying that they're like more dickheadish than an average dude. So I haven't done that. Just clarifying, you know, just in case you thought I had gone to that extent for the sake of an obscure question that may or may not have ever, you know, presented itself on these Twitter questionnaires. But anyway, I mean, they can be dickheads, and they can be dickheads because I'm talking about the United States here, obviously. They aren't held accountable. They can do whatever they want. They can pretty much strut around above the law because if it comes right down to it, if there's ever a situation where there's more than one cop against you or your friends or something, they're just going to corroborate their evidence and all of their testimony, and they're going to beat you because they're going to go with the cop's word over yours every time. And the only way to have evidence against something like a fallacious like pullover and they're searching your car, unless you have a camera rolling, they're just going to delete the camera that they have on their dash, or just going to turn it off before they do anything. So there's not really that much you can do. You know, in Missouri, I remember. It was like a few weeks ago that I saw something online that said that a lot of Missouri cops were trying to make it so that the police cam that records the back of your car when they pull you over, they're trying to make it so that they don't have to use those anymore. So it's pretty much like them saying, we're going to be doing things that are not legal. We don't want to be held accountable. Like, it's just a club that we're not in. And we, as much as they say, like, the policeman is your friend, I can say I'm way more afraid from a police officer than I am from, like, if I see, like, a couple gang members or, like, a skinhead walking towards me, you know? I don't know. It's just a visceral reaction now. Like, oh, cop, heart beats up, kind of scared, you know, tingles on my skin, don't want to get in trouble. Like, it's just, it's scary, and it shouldn't be that way. Todd, get a better name. Talk about Batman versus Spider-Man. I would rather be Batman because he's rich as shit and Spider-Man's a wussy little baby and he's not that cool. Or at least the guy, or Toby, whoever the hell, Toby Maguire, that's not the name of the actual guy. That was the the Spider-Man, the shitty Spider-Man series actor. But Batman's cooler, but Spider-Man actually has powers, so that really bends in his favor. But then again, who needs powers when you have billions of dollars at your disposal? You know? You don't. That's the answer. One Mach Zero, trees, fish, donkeys mating. Trees, fantastically thankful for their contribution to the quality of the air that I breathe. Fish, very tasty. Big fan of some cod or maybe even a tilapia. And donkeys mating, I'm fine with it. It's a natural process, but for the most part, I prefer to distance myself. Expect greatness. Butt sex. Thank you for your long and articulate question. This really delves to the heart of the kind of thing I want to address in these videos, just to make sure you know that. I mean, butt sex, go for it. I mean, as long as it's consensual, go hog wild, you know, do whatever you want. Hog wild. What the hell is up? I never say that saying in real life. Is it a saying? That's probably a saying. I don't say it in real life, though, and it's weird how I say these things randomly in videos that I would never even think to say in real life. That's weird how I keep referring to it as real life, as though I'm in some other dimension right now promoting or making these videos from like a weird plane and non-existence, and then I come back to reality when I take off these Astro A40s. Whatever, though. Talk about your favorite anime as a kid from Infinity Boy. I didn't really watch anime, but it was Pokemon. I got the same question, actually. So if you asked that question before, sir, I answered it for you. I answered it for you, and the answer is Pokemon. You're welcome for answering twice and not doing that annoying teacher thing where they're like, "Oh yeah, if you didn't listen the first time, then I'm not going to repeat it for you." And I'm like, "That's your goddamn job, is repeating things until I can retain the information that you're required to teach me." And then I just, you know, they don't like smart asses, and so I didn't do well. In the Purify, competitive pros not getting enough attention, hates crazy scoring commentators such as. I'm not going to mention names of other people because pros are better. I have no idea what you're trying to ask, man. Like, there's not much punctuation in there, and of the punctuation, there isn't even a question mark. So I don't even know what's going on here. I'm going to say yes to you. Yes, yes is the answer. Naxhorn, extreme feminism. I mean, I had to take a class where we learned a lot about feminism just because, not because I was interested, because I realize it's a ridiculous, trite concept that's completely nonsensical and antiquated, where, I mean, all their goals have come to fruition. And so it was irritating to sit in that class, but I took it because I knew it would be really easy, and it was easy. Pretty much every answer, if I was just like, "I'm an evil piece of shit because I'm a white male, I'm evil just because of who I am. Everybody else needs to take pride in their culture except for me. I'm shit." And that was pretty much just how it makes you feel about yourself, even though you're not implicated at all in the schemes of these other supposed white males that are ruling the world, which not going to debate that point. So yeah, I could do a whole video on feminism. I think it's pretty ridiculous. It's antiquated. There's no reason for them to continue and freak out. And it's just trying to achieve equality of the genders by just entirely focusing all resources and efforts on women and not giving a shit about men. So it's kind of silly to me. Real MJ, oh, real VMJ. Your most embarrassing moments. Someone's asked this before. I'll come back to you. I'll make a whole video about it. I need to think of some embarrassing moments because I got some doozies in my past. Awesome Sauce 141, telling religious parents that you are an atheist. Honestly, if it depends on your parents. If you're super, or if you come rather from a super religious family and you think they're gonna disown you if you say it, then just keep it a secret, man. Wait till you're out of college. Wait till you're a little bit more distanced from them, and then tell them because there's no reason putting yourself and them through that stress. Or if they're really lax and lenient about it and don't really care, like it was with my family, just come out, say what you have to say, use facts and argumentation. Don't come out in a little rebellious bastard kind of way, like, "I'm not going to do what you do because that's gay," or just some shit like that. So just make sure you're mature, come out, have arguments, and then you should be fine if your parents are reasonable people. But when in doubt, just keep it a secret, you know? It's not worth ruining a relationship with your parents over. Toof Zach, talk about your guilty pleasures. Guilty pleasures. You know, at my apartment, this isn't really a guilty pleasure, but it is weird in a weird kind of sadist kind of way. But they changed the way that the light outside my apartment worked, and so instead of it being on when I chose for it to be on, this really, really bright light was on constantly 24/7. I don't know why they did it this way, but they did. And so if I were to walk out on my porch or be getting back from somewhere, there'd always be a shit ton of moths just flying around, just buzzing, doing their thing. And I'm talking about an egregious number of moths, just a crazy amount of moths, all of them each bigger and fatter and hairier than the last. And I just hate moths so much. And so what I would do is I would open obviously, the door to my apartment, and then one or two of them would fly in. And if I had kept it open, like all of them would have come in, but I also could have closed it fast enough that none of them came in. And so I'd let like one or two in, then close it real quick, and then proceed to take my shoe off and kill those one or two. And in my head, I was just like, yeah, you bastards, thought you could come in here, thought you could come into my house, thought you could invade my safe space, and just like get all angry about it. But I don't know. I guess that is a pretty weird thing to do. That's probably, if I'm saying something and it sounds like a weird thing to do, then chances are you guys listening to it are like, what the fuck is his problem? Unsubscribing or whatever the hell. But, yeah.